this is just a quick shortcut for converting standard form of a linear equation to slope-intercept form. Now, standard form is ax plus by equals c, and slope-intercept is y equals mx plus b. For example, let's say that you had 3x plus 4y is equal to 12. That's going to be the same as y equals negative 3/4 x plus 3. Now, there's an algebraic way of doing that, but there's a quick way, too. Their slope is going to be a over b, and then change the sign. That's going to be 3 over 4, and then change the sign to a negative. Negative 3 over 4, already done. It's right there. To find b, your y-intercept, all you have to do is take c and put it over b. We're just going to take 12 over 4. 12 divided by 4 is 3. There it is right there. That's the whole shortcut, just memorizing negative a over b and c over b. It's really quick. Let's go ahead and do another example of that. Now, we've got all of our shortcuts over here to the side to refer to. It's just something quick to memorize. Let's say they ask you to graph 2x minus 3y is equal to 6. Well, a is 2, b is negative 3, and c is going to be 6. Well, to find the slope, all you're going to have to do is remember it's negative a over b. You just change the sign, put a over b, and then change the sign. So all we have to do is take the 2, put it over a negative 3. That makes negative 2/3, but we have to change that sign so it becomes a positive 2 over 3. Well, what about the y-intercept? Well, the y-intercept is just going to be c over b. Well, c is 6, and b is negative 3, so we're just going to write 6 divided by negative 3, positive divided by negative, it's going to give you a negative 2. Well, we're done. That's it. Y is equal to 2/3 x minus 2. So we've transformed it into slope-intercept form. Well, the original question was to graph it. So we start with our slope-intercept form, and we're just going to use that to put it onto a graph. It's much easier in that form than it is in standard form. So you start with your y-intercept of negative 2. Just put a dot right there at the negative 2 and use your slope. Positive 2 over 3, we're going to go up 2 and over 3 to the right. Up 2 over 3, and draw your line. Quick and easy. Let's go ahead and do another question. So what if they ask you if these two linear equations are equivalent? Are they the same? Well, you can use your shortcut again. A is going to be 10, B is going to be 2, and C is going to be 8. So you see, is the slope over here going to be the same as the slope over there? We take A over B and change the sign. 10 over 2, and change the sign to a negative. 10 divided by 2 is going to be 5, so it's negative 5. So you can see right there, yes, that's the same. So far, so good. Well, let's look at the y-intercept. Remember, the y-intercept is going to be c over b, so we just take 8 divided by 2. 8 over 2 is 4. And so, yes, that's going to be exactly the same as the other. They are equivalent. Let's try one more example. Okay, let's write this equation in slope-intercept form. Remember, you don't have to use this shortcut, but it's much quicker. Now, just remember, if x is all by itself, that the a is going to be 1. Negative 2 is going to be b, and positive 10 is going to be c. Let me just plug it into our little formula to make it into slope-intercept form. Y equals mx plus b. Now, all we have to do is find m. M is going to be blank. And we need to find b, our y-intercept. So our slope is going to be a over b, change the sign. That's 1 over negative 2. So we take 1 over negative 2 and then change whatever that sign is going to be. 1 over negative 2 is negative 1 half, so change the sign becomes positive 1 half. So B, that y-intercept, it's going to be C over B. Remember, we don't change the sign, just put C over B. That's 10 over negative 2, and 10 divided by negative 2 is negative 5. So instead of a positive, instead of a plus, we're going to write minus 5. And that's it. It's that quick. But again, remember, you don't have to use this shortcut, but it does make things much easier to transform it if you just remember negative A over B and C over B.